That old thing. It's a beautiful piece. You're about to do, so.
I know.
Get over it.
I'm like, oh, it's coming. Okay.
You're gonna find stillness and zen. It's gonna be awesome.
Your turn. I'm so excited. Bases.
But the problem is, am I looking like the music, or am I looking like a timekeeper? Mm-hmm. You know? See. Too much. So your job is down,
ready? And then when you hear something pretty, let's hear that tenor line. And then everybody's like, ooh, let's listen to that tenor line. It must be gorgeous. She's paying attention to it. Oh, here comes the bass. Oh, listen. Oh, soprano's like, we have bassists in this choir? Right? Because what you attend to, they will attend to. And they need to know where your musical thought is so they can follow. You know, and the poor sopranos are left to their own devices in this piece because they're usually the last and the bassist. The sopranos and bassist in this piece are kind of lost because they start these things and have these interesting.
Well, and it is the same, except the only one is really this one at the very end that I noticed.
That's right.
Yeah.
And see, look at the how far. How far apart those are.
Yeah.
You know. It's almost impossible. Mm-hmm. So you have to know where you want to be. Where's your audiation in those moments, and that will help you make decisions as who to conduct. You have to leave it to their own devices. Mm-hmm. You can't give everything, every cue, every interest. And that's what we're taught all the time, isn't it? Mm-hmm. We have to bring the sprinkle objective. They can count. They're only off one beat. You know, they can breathe and they come back in. Shh. I want to hear what's going on. Altos, this isn't learned quite well enough to carry the piece. You're important.
Thanks.
Beautiful. Some really.